गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज सतीश सर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी फोर्थ लेक्चर इन न्यूटन्स लॉ. दोज हु कंप्लीटेड टेंथ क्लास, वेलकम टू इंटरमीडिएट फर्स्ट ईयर क्लास 11. दिस इज कंप्लीटली एनसीईआरटी सिलेबस. टोटल इंडेक्स आल्सो आई विल डू वन मोर वीडियो. हियर नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग विथ न्यूटन लॉस ऑफ मोशन, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस इज फोर्थ लेक्चर इन न्यूटन लॉस. टिल नाउ वाट वी डिस्कस्ड, summary we will see once, then after we will go to our topic. Today's topic is Atwood machine. What is the use of Atwood machine? What we can prove with this instrument? All these things we will see now. Before going to see, first of all I will remind you previous topics, summary we will see once. In Newton laws of motion, what we saw in first law? What is Newton first law? If a body is at rest only. If a body is in motion, if a body is in uniform motion, it continues its uniform motion unless and until external force acting on it. Suppose if I kept a chalk piece here, I kept this marker here. If you come after 10 years also, this chalk piece will be here only. Planets are revolving around the sun, that is uniform motion. That means it continues its uniform motion unless and until any external force and acting on it. Suppose another planet comes to that planet, and if it hits that planet, then only it changes its path. Till then it moves in uniform motion only. That means planets are revolving around the sun in elliptical path. It continues its path unless and until external force acting on the body. This is what a uniform motion. Uniform motion is nothing but planets revolving around the sun. This is what if a body is at rest. This is at rest only. That means initial velocity zero, it's zero only. It do not change its position unless and until acting external force on it. That means net acceleration is zero in first law. In Newton first law, net acceleration is zero. We don't consider acceleration. All bodies acceleration will be zero. What is mean by acceleration zero? Acceleration zero means F net is also zero. Why? Because F is equal to ma. If A is zero, automatically the total term will be zero. Zero into something is zero. So F net is also zero. But velocity is not zero, friends. Velocity is constant. Velocity is constant. Example, Earth is revolving around the sun with how much speed? 1540 kilometer per hour. If you have any doubt, go to previous lecture, Newton laws of motion 1, Newton laws of motion 2, Newton laws of motion 3. First three videos you see, complete lecture in detailed I told in those videos. 1540 kilometer per hour in 1 hour. Let us consider now the time is 10 p.m. if you check 11 p.m. also its speed is same, no? That means initial velocity, final velocity, both are same. That is also 1540. Then what is acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but rate of change in velocity, V minus U by T. 1540 minus 1540. How much? Zero. Zero by something? Zero by something is zero. So acceleration will be, net acceleration will be zero. But velocity is constant. Velocity, whenever you see, whatever the time you see, it may be it's 7 o'clock, it may be 10 o'clock, whatever it is, velocity is always constant. But what is zero? Net acceleration is zero, net force is zero. This is what Newton first law. In Newton first law, one more important thing, we consider initial velocity u meter per second, final velocity v meter per second, acceleration a meter per second square, and time here to here t seconds, and distance traveled by the body s meter. Only these five terms we will consider, but force, net force we will not consider. Net force is always zero. This is very important topic. If net force is zero, then the body is called in uniform motion or at rest. This is what Newton first law. Understand? Now we will see Newton second law. In Newton first law, so many problems we did. In Newton first law, what we saw? Types of forces we saw. Contact force, non-contact force. non-contact forces, gravitational force, tensional force, these are all comes under magnetic force, electrostatic force, these are all comes under non-contact force. Contact force are nothing but normal force. Normal force is a contact force. Tension force is a contact force. These are all contact forces. See here, suppose if you kept a body here, it is always attracted towards the center of the earth. This is called mg. This surface always pulls upwards. This is called normal. Normal always perpendicular to the contact. This is what contact, perpendicular to the contact is called normal. Normal is equal to mg. Remember, normal is always perpendicular to the contact. You have to take from the contact. Contact to perpendicular normal, center of the object to downwards mg. This is called weight. Weight means what? The gravitational force acting on a body towards the center of the earth. Every body is, suppose I am standing here, earth center is pulling me downwards, not only me, every object on the planet, every object on the earth is attracted by the earth towards its center. This is what gravitational force. Gravitational force also denoted by W. W is equal to nothing. Weight is nothing but a gravitational force acting on a body towards the center of the earth. W is equal to mg. W is also nothing but a force only. Weight is also nothing but force. Its unit is also Newton. You can say kg weight also. Kg weight or Newton. 1 kg weight is equal to 9.8 Newton. Remember, this is also very important. Unit of weight is kg weight or Newton. Weight formula W is equal to mg. Normal is a contact force. Normal force is always perpendicular to the contact. This is what contact. This is what perpendicular. You have to take from perpendicular. Weight always acts towards the center, from the center of the mass. Let us consider this is a body. This is a book. From the center of the book, the weight downwards. Understand, children? Suppose human being. What is the center of the human being? Novel. From the novel, the earth is attracting towards its center. So the weight is always acts towards the center of the earth. This is what a gravitational force. Understand, children? Now we will see Newton's second law. Newton's laws of motion. Newton's second law. What is Newton's second law? Newton's second law is nothing but F is equal to ma. Newton's second law is nothing but F is equal to m into a. Here we will consider force also. F net is equal to ma. Here we will consider initial velocity of the object u. Let us consider this is a road. On this road, one car is going on. Its initial velocity is u meter per second. Final velocity, after some time it reaches here to here. After some time its velocity is v meter per second. Here to here it takes t seconds. The distance here to here is s meter. And acceleration is a meter per second square. What is acceleration? Rate of change in velocity, v minus u by t. Here initial velocity is, let us consider 5 meter per second. Here 20 meter per second. What is the difference 20 minus 5? That is 15. In how many seconds? Let us consider 5 seconds. 5. 5 ones, 5 threes. 3 meter per second square is the acceleration. That means this car is accelerating 3 meter per second square in which direction? In left to right direction. This is what acceleration. In addition to all these, we will consider force also. How much force acts on the car to move here to here? What kind of force is acting on the car? All these things we will consider in Newton's second law of motion. Newton's second law of motion, so many problems we did in third video. Today we will see some more problems on Newton's second law. Most important problems based on Atwood vision. Third law, you know very well, third law. In third law, action and reaction are equal. Action is equal to reaction, but opposite. Action and reaction are equal and opposite. This is what Newton's third law. Newton's third law, simply we can say, if you hit a nail, how much you hit, that nail goes that much inside the wall. That means action is equal to reaction. Suppose you are swimming. How much water you pull towards your stomach, that much forward you will go. That means action is equal and opposite to the reaction. If you pull water towards, you go forward direction. That means action and reaction are equal and opposite. So action is equal to minus reaction. Minus means both are opposite. This is Newton's third law. in Newton third law, we will do so many previous IIT numericals. If you go in lift, what will happen? What will be your weight if you go upside? If lift is coming down, what will be your weight? If lift is, example, lift is at rest, what is your weight on weighing machine? These are all. If suddenly wire cuts, string of the lift cuts, what will be your weight? All these things we will discuss in Newton third law. Now, in this video, we are going to see Atwood machine. Atwood is a scientist. What is Atwood machine? Oh, 1 minute. Just I'll fill the ink. See, children, Atwood machine helps to prove all three Newton laws at a time. What is Atwood machine? See here, this is a ceiling. Ceiling means nothing but roof. This is what ceiling. This is a pulley. This is what pulley. Pulley is covered with one string. This is what string. One side it is suspended M1 mass. Another side it is suspended M2 mass. By seeing this diagram only, you can say M2 is greater than M1. This is what Atwood machine. Atwood machine consists of a pulley fixed to a ceiling, and it is covered with a string, and it is two weights are suspended at two ends of the string. This is what Atwood machine. What is the use of Atwood machine? We will see. By seeing this diagram, immediately you can say that already I told you only one string. These two masses are attached to single string. So if string is same, tension is also same. Here, what is the direction of string? Tension. What is the tension direction? Away from the mass. Sit on in this mass, just open this umbrella, tension will be upwards. If tension is upwards, this is the tension acts by the mass on the pulley. Similarly, same tension is applied by the pulley on the mass. Same tension will be applied here, T. Why? Because action and reaction are equal and opposite. This is the tension force applied by M1 mass on this pulley. This is what same tension applied by pulley on the mass. These two are equal and opposite. String is same. Here also tension will be same. Here also tension will be same. Any doubt, children? This is what a tension force applied by M2 on pulley. This is what tension force applied by pulley on mass. These two are equal and opposite in direction. According to Newton's third law, just now we saw action and reaction are equal and opposite. Now observe carefully, children. From this center, what is the weight of this body? Weight is nothing but mass into gravity, m2g. Weight is upwards, tension is upwards, weight is downwards. What is the weight of this body? m1g downwards. Now make it free body diagram, FBD diagram, FBD of m2. First we will write m2. What is m2? Take it as point object. Why? Because what, even it is a planet also, take it as point object. Consider it as a point object. Make them free out. Now, this is what M2, mass 2. What is the weight acting on the body? M2G. What is the tension? Upwards T. Which force is more? M2 is more or M1 is more? M2 is more. We considered M2 is more than M1. So, this body comes down, this body goes up. Is it right? Why? Because its weight is more. So, it comes down. So, net force is equal to what? Net force is equal to MA formula. According to Newton's law, what is net force? M2g weight downwards, tension upwards. So, net force is M2g minus T is equal to MA. M means we are saying that M mass to M2 into A. This is what we got first equation from this M2. Similarly, you do FBD of M2. FBD of M1. M2 is completed and M1. Make M1 free. Free body diagram. This is what M1. M1G downwards. M1G downwards. Tension upwards. This body is going up. That means this tension force is more than M1G. So this force minus this force. Net force is nothing but this force minus this force. Simply observe that this is a string. This is a rope. I am pulling with 100 Newton. Here you are pulling with 50 Newton. That means which direction it moves? Towards myself it moves. So net force is 100 minus 50. Only 50 Newton force is applied on this string. Understand? So 100 minus 50. Here also same. Tension is upwards. M1 is G is downwards. So this pulley is coming down. This mass is coming down. Automatically it goes up. So tension 1 is more than M1G. T1 net force is equal to. Same formula I am applying here. T minus M1G is equal to. Net force MA. M is what? M1 into A. This is what equation number 2. If you solve these two, you will get acceleration and tension. You can find acceleration and tension of the earthward mission. This is what net acceleration. If you know net acceleration, directly you can substitute F is equal to MA. You will get the force acting on M1. You will get the force acting on M2. Here force is nothing but tension. So you will get tension. If you substitute here, you will get tension. Now we will see, we will solve these two. I am going to rub this. See children, from what is the first equation? Equation 1 and 2 I am solving. 1 plus 2 I am doing. M2G minus T is equal to M2A. T minus M1G is equal to M1A. Add these two. Plus T minus T cancel. M2G minus M1G is equal to A common. M1 plus M2 into A. So, I want the acceleration. No? Acceleration of this outward mission I want. Acceleration is equal to, here G is common. M2 minus M1 by M1 plus M2 into G. This is the direct formula to find the acceleration of the outward mission. If two bodies are suspended over a pulley, remember, try to understand children. Two masses are suspended over a pulley which is attached to ceiling. What is the acceleration of the body? With what acceleration the body comes down? With what acceleration the body goes up? With what acceleration M1 goes up? With what acceleration M1 comes down? Simply, M2G minus M1G by M1 plus M2. Simple friends, F is equal to MA, A is equal to F by M. F is nothing but MG. M2G minus M1G, net force, larger force minus smaller force by total mass. Total mass is M1 plus M2. Now, from this formula only, we will find the tension. How do you get tension? This acceleration value substitute here, you will get the tension. Are you able to see here? I will check mobile once. Okay, it is clear. Substitute in one. Substitute in one. A value in one. What is this? M2G minus T is equal to M2A. So, I want tension. Tension is equal to what will happen? M2G, this T goes to that side. It becomes plus. M2A comes to this side. So, M2A. So, T is equal to M2 common, G minus A. What is A value? Complete this value. I am going to substitute here. M2 minus M1 by M1 plus M2 into G. G also common. T is equal to M2G into 1 minus, directly I will do, M1 plus M2 is LCM, M1 plus M2 minus M2 plus M1. Plus M1 minus M1 cancel. Sorry, M1 is not cancel. M2 plus M2 minus M2 cancel. Here M1 plus M1, 2M1. So the final answer is T is equal to 2M1 M2G by M1 plus M2. This is the tension acting in the tension acting on the outward mission string. Acceleration is M2 minus M1 by M1 plus M2 into G. Net force by net mass. M2G minus M1G by M1 plus M2. Net tension is equal to, what is the tension of the string? Only one string is there. Wherever you see, the tension is same. If you see here or here or here or here, wherever you see, tension is same. 2 into M1 M2 by 2M1 M2G by M1 plus M2. Most important problem, most important derivation, outward mission. Sir, you said all phenomena you can prove with the outward mission. No? How can you prove it? Let us consider two masses are same. Outward mission, what is outward mission? A pulley is present. it is attached to the ceiling, it is suspended over a pulley, two masses are attached at two ends. If let us consider two masses are same, then what will happen? Then two masses are at rest. Two masses are at rest. So Newton's first law is proved. What is Newton's first law? If a body is at rest only. Suppose if the body applied some force, then it comes into motion. M1 goes up, M2 comes down, then it comes in Newton's second law. Newton's third law, just now we saw, tension is upwards. Tension acting by M2 on pulley is MT. Pulley acting tension, same tension on M2. So T and T both are equal and opposite. Newton's third law is also proved. All Newton's three laws we can prove with the help of Atwood machine. Copy it. We will do some problems based on this Atwood machine. Very, very important. Any doubt you can practice once. Any doubt again you can write in comment section. I will explain once again. First of all, copy it. Right, okay children, how to do this problem in shortcut? Is there any shortcut? Definitely there will be a shortcut. No need to do all these things. Acceleration is equal to net force by net mass. You have m2g. If m2 is greater than m1, m2g minus m1, m2g minus m1g by m1 plus m2 acceleration. Tension 2m1 m2 into g by m1 plus m2. All these things you no need to do. Simply how to find acceleration of the mass, the string, how to find the acceleration of the system, that we will see. Suppose just now we saw this is what pulley, this is what ceiling. A string is attached to that pulley. Here M2 is greater than M1. This is M2, this is M1. M2 is greater than M1. Then this body definitely comes down. M2G is more than M2G. This is tension T. Here this is tension T. M1G. This is tension T. This is tension T. This is the tension acts by M1 on pulley. This is the tension acts by pulley on mass. These two are equal and opposite. These two are equal and opposite. Similarly, tension acts by M2 on pulley. This is the tension acts by pulley on M. String is same. Tension is same. Now, what I am doing? This I am expanding. This total system without pulley, just imagine you place on the table, horizontal table, then what will happen? This is the string, this is what M2, this is what M1, here remaining portion tension T, this is what M1G, this is M1G, this is M2G. Now here what is happening? This is tension T, this is tension T. Now observe children. Body is sliding in this direction. That means net acceleration will be in M2G. Acceleration will be in this direction. That means body is accelerating in this direction. What is the acceleration formula? Net acceleration formula? F by M. F is equal to MA. A is equal to F by M. What is net force? Net force is nothing but this side M2G, this side M1G. So M2G minus M1G. This is the net force by net mass. Net mass is nothing but total mass, M1 plus M2. This is what acceleration of the pulley. Any doubt? This acceleration you substitute in one equation, you will get the tension. Tension, there is no other way. There is no shortcut for tension. Tension you should write like this only. So M2G minus T is equal to M2A. Now substitute this acceleration formula in this equation, then you will get tension. But acceleration directly you can find net force by net mass. Net force is nothing but in which direction the body is sliding. In that direction you take mg, other direction m1g, m2g minus m1g by net force, net mass m1 plus m2. If you do this you can do within a fraction of minutes, 15 to 20 seconds, you can solve this problem. We are going to see all these problems one by one. Before going to see, you need to understand the concept. So Atwood machine is a scientist. It is an instrument. This instrument is also named as Atwood machine. It is used to prove all Newton three laws. What is Newton first law? If a body is at rest only. If a body is in uniform motion, it continues its uniform motion till unless and until external force acts on the body. This is what Newton's first law, very important, but less scope is there in IIT means. Why? Because Newton's second law, we get more number of problems. Newton's first law is very simple, finding force we will not consider, no, so it will be very easy. Newton first law, I did a one and a half hour video. You go through first video, all Newton first law problems you can solve very easily. Then after you can use any referring books. I am using Hariharan book. Arihant book, this is Hariharan series. Arihant book I am using. Complete concept oriented. First of all, solve it. Then after you go to H.C. Verma, it will be easy to solve. Directly you cannot understand H.C. Verma. Before going to solve H.C. Verma, you take Arihant series. Arihant series is the best way to understand the concepts. Concepts will be very easy. First go through Arihant series. Then after you solve any problem. Right? This is what Atwood mission. Now we are going to see problems one by one. First of all, copy it. See children, this is 5 kg, this is 2 kg, this is 4 kg. Here the question is, first question note down, find tension and acceleration of the system. Find the tension and acceleration of the system. How to find the tension? General method is somewhat difficult, that also we will see. First of all, how many forces acting on the body? See here how many strings are there? First of all, try to understand, this is one string, this is another string. Strings changes, so tension also changes. Let us consider the tension acts by 2 kg on pulley is T1. This pulley acts same tension on 2 kg, T1. String is same, tension is same. This is also same string, 5 kg acting T1 force on pulley, T1, this is also acting T1 force on the 5 kg mass. Tension changes, 2 kg acting T2 tension on 4 kg, 4 kg acting T2 tension on 2 kg. Understand children, string changes, tension changes. Tension is always away from the point. This is 4 kg, already I told you in first video, just sit here and open umbrella. In which direction umbrella opens, that is the direction of tension. If you want tension of the 2 kg, acts on 4 kg, sit on 2 kg, open umbrella 4 kg side. So tension will be downwards. Here tension will be upwards. Now observe children. First we will do shortcut, then after general method also we will see. First of all, I need acceleration. What is acceleration? Net force by net mass. Net mass. Sir, why you are putting arrow marks? Why? Because it is a vector. So I am putting arrow mark. What is net force? Net force, in which direction it is acting? 4 kg is acting downwards, mg. Mg is nothing but 4g. Are you able to see? 4g. This is what? 5g. Here, this force is acting 2g. 2g downwards. Weight always acts downwards from the center. Normal force means contact force. There is no contact, so there is no normal force. So, F net. What is F net? M2g, body is sliding in which direction? This is total mass 6 plus 2, 6 kg. 6 kg means this mass is more than this mass. This mass is more than this mass. So definitely body slides in this direction. So M2, let us consider this total mass is how much? 6 kg. 6 kg. This is 6 kg, this is 5 kg. So body slides downwards. This is M2g. 6g, this is 5g. So net mass, what is the formula? M2g minus M1g by net force, M1 plus M2. M2 is nothing but this total mass, 6g. 6g minus 5g, this is 5g, 6g downwards, 5g down, 5 upwards. Total mass is 6, this total system is 6 plus 5, 11. Total mass is 11. So 6g minus 5g, 1g, 1g by 11. G by 11 is the acceleration of the system. What is the acceleration of the system? G by 11. G by 11 is the acceleration of the system. Remember, G by 11 is the acceleration of the system. Then, sir, how to find tension? Tension is very simple. Here you have to find two tensions. First of all, we will find this tension. 4 kg, make free body 4 kg. 4 kg. point mass, considered as point mass, 4g downwards, tension T2 upwards. So T2 is balancing 4g, T2 is equal to 4g, T2 is equal to 40 newton. I got T2, acceleration I got, T2 I got. Now how to find T1? T1, just observe friends, can I rub this? You can pause and write it. First of all, you practice it on your own. If you did not get, then only you watch the video or cross check the video. How to get T1? Observe children. T1 is upwards. This T1 is 2 kg, take 2 kg, point mass 2 kg. T1 is upwards. T2 is downwards. Another force is also there downwards. What is that? 2g. That means upward force is equal to downward forces. This is T1. T1 is equal to 2g plus T2. Understand? Sum of these forces equal to upward force. Sum of downward forces equal to sum of upward forces. 2g. 2 into 10, 20. T2 value just we got 40. 20 plus 40, how much? 60 newton. This is what T1. T1 is equal to 60 newton. T2 is equal to 40 newton. And acceleration is equal to g by 11. If you want more simplification, you can do 10 by 11 meter per second square. Meter per second square. Tension 1, tension 2, and acceleration. This is the way of doing Atwood mission problems. Understand children? Very important. Previous IIT bit. How to find the tension in Atwood mission? How to find the acceleration of the system? How to find the tension, different tensions and different strings? If string changes, tension also changes. How to find all these with the help of Atwood mission? Simple way. Net force is equal to MA. A is equal to net force by net mass. Net force, how do you get? M2g minus M1g by total mass M1 plus M2. Substitute in any one of the equation, tension equations, you will get tension. Understand children? Very important concept, note down. See children, next problem. This is what ceiling. This is what pulley. Here I suspended 1 kg mass, 1 kg. This is what 3 kg. One pulley is there. One pulley is suspended to ceiling. And a string is suspended over a pulley and it is attached to 2 masses, 1 kg and 3 kg. Now, second question. The question is find acceleration and tension of the system. First we will do general method, make it as a weight downwards, mg downwards, 3g downwards, same string, so same tension, only one tension. Tension acts by 3 kg on pulley. This is a tension acts by pulley on 3 kg. Same tension, same string, same tension. Tension acts by 1 kg on pulley. This is the tension acts by pulley on tension. Now see children, first write FBD diagram of 3 kg. Then after we will do shortcut, general method I am saying, this is what solution. Make it as free, 3 kg, 3g downwards, tension T upwards. Which body slides down? 3 kg is greater than 1 kg. So definitely this body slides down. So M2g, F net is equal to, what is the formula? M into A net. F net, how do you get F net? F net is equal to MA. How do you get F net? F net is nothing but weight. 3g minus T. Weight is MG downwards, T upwards. So net force is this force minus this force is equal to MA, 3A. This is what equation number 1. Similarly, write FBD of 1 kg. This is what 1 kg tension, 1 kg down, 1g downwards, weight downwards, no, 1 into g, 1g downwards, T upwards, body is sliding up, m2g minus m1g is equal to ma, 1 into a. This is equation number 2. If you solve these two, you will get acceleration. Solve 1 and 2. How to solve? Do 1 plus 2. 3g minus t is equal to 3a. T minus 1g is equal to 1a. TT cancel. 3g minus 1g. 2g is equal to 4a. a is equal to 2g by 4. 2 ones, 2 twos. G is 10. 10 by 2. Acceleration is nothing but 5 meter per second square. That means this body is coming 5 meter per second square. Each second, well, what is mean by 5 meter per second? Acceleration is equal to velocity by time. Velocity is nothing but 5 meter per second. 5 meter per second by time, second. That means each second it is coming 5 meter. 5 meter per second per second. Velocity is 5 meter per second in each second. That is what accelerating. This is coming 5 meter per second means this is going upwards in 5 meter per second. Now we got acceleration. Now we need tension. How do you get tension? Substitute here. Substitute a value in 1. Substitute a value in equation number 1. What is equation number 1? 3g minus t is equal to 3a. 3g minus t is equal to 3a. 3g minus t is equal to 3 into a. A is nothing but 15. G is 10. 30 minus t is equal to 45. T send to that side. A is equal to 5 meter per second. 3g minus t is equal to 3a. A is nothing but 5. Sorry, not 15. A is 5. 5 threes are 15. T is equal to T goes to that side, it means plus 30 minus 15. 30 minus 15 is nothing but tension is 20 Newton. Tension in the string is 20 Newton. Acceleration is 5 meter per second square. If 3 kg comes 5 meter per second square down, 1 meter goes 5 meter per second square up. This is what? A very important problem in active admission. Now see children, this total problem you no need to do. Sir, how to do simple way? Are you told in shortcut? No. Again, you are doing all this big way to solve this problem. How to solve this problem in a simple way? Simple. Already I told you. How to find the acceleration? Acceleration is equal to F by M. F is equal to M, A is equal to F by M. F is nothing but net force. What is net force? M2g minus 3g minus 1g by total mass, net mass. What is net mass? 3 plus 1, 4. 3g minus 1g, 2g. 2g into g value, how much? 10 by 4. 2 ones, 2 twos, 2 ones, 2 fives. Acceleration is equal to 5 meter per second. Only one step, 5 meter per second square. How to get tension? Right. Here this body is sliding downwards. 3g minus t is equal to ma, 3a. So, t is equal to what will happen? This t goes that side, 3a comes to this side. 3g minus 3a. 3g is 30 minus 15, 20 Newton. Simple way. You no need to do, simply you can think and answer it. Very simple. F is equal to ma. In denominator, total masses. Numerator, m2g minus m1g. This is mg, 30. This is 10. 30 minus 10, 20. In numerator, 20. Denominator 3 plus 1, 4. 20 by 4, that is about 5. Acceleration is 5. Tension also very simple. This one sliding up. T minus G is equal to 1A. T minus G is equal to NA. A, T is equal to A plus G. A is 5, G is 10. 15, answer is 15. You can come from this also. Simple way. This is third problem in active admission, children. See here. Here it is suspended a pulley. One block is there. It is suspended over a pulley. It is suspended over a pulley. It is attached to two masses. This is 5 kg mass. This is 1 kg mass. 5 kg, 1 kg. Now the question is, find same question. Question there is no change. Find tension and acceleration. Find tension. Tension is also force only. Find tension and force of the system. Tension and acceleration of system. How to find? Here, this is another way, another model. See children, this body only normal force is acting. There is no external force. This body is moving forward because of this body. Is it right? If 1 kg accelerates downwards, that much acceleration takes place in 5 kg. There is no other force. Why 5 kg is moving? 5 kg is moving because of 1 kg. If 1 kg slides down, comes down, how much it accelerates, same acceleration takes place in 5 kg. Try to understand. Both are attached with only one string. So here tension is upwards. Tension acts by 1 kg on pulley. Same tension acts by pulley on 1 kg. Here also same string means same tension. Tension is same. This is tension is same. Sir, how sir, it is suspended over a pulley. There is no suspension. Then how the tension takes place? This tension takes place not because of this 5 kg. This tension takes place in the string because of 1 kg. Suppose 5 kg is also suspended, the tension may be different. But 5 kg simply it is at rest on the surface. It is a smooth surface. In all these problems, there is no friction between this surface. It is a smooth polished surface. Now, what is the tension? What is the acceleration? Before going to find acceleration, first of all, try to understand what is the weight of this body? 1g. Mg means 1g. Now, observe carefully. Make it free body diagram. General way we will do first. FBD of 1 kg. How to do 1 kg FBD? Simple. It is coming down. So, F net is equal to MA. F is equal to MA, F net, what is net force? 1G minus T, it is coming downwards. So, this force minus this force, net force, MG minus T is equal to MA, M is 1 into A. So, simply we can write G minus T is equal to A, equation number 1. Any doubt, children? Simple, I am making free body diagram for 1 kg. Now, FBD of 5 kg, how to write 5 kg FBD? 5 kg, there are no external forces. There is only one force is acting on that body. That is what? Tension force. There is no other force. There is no weight. Sir, weight is all, you said weight always acts towards the center of the earth. No doubt it acts towards the center, but that is cancelled by normal force. Normal, why? Because there is a contact. There is a contact. It is not accelerating downwards or upwards, it is accelerating in forward direction because of 1 kg. So, contact force is there means automatically normal force exists. Normal force is always cancelled by gravitational force. N is simply cancelled by 5g. So, you no need to consider this one, you no need to consider. If you want, you can, if they ask what is the normal of 5 kg means, directly you can see N is equal to 5g or 50. Now, here 5 kg is sliding, 5 kg is accelerating in this direction. So, because of tension T is equal to nothing but 5 T is here, this body is sliding in this direction, acceleration. So 5 kg force, F is equal to MA, F is nothing but T is equal to 5 into acceleration is 5A. This is equation number 2. If you solve these two, you will get tension and acceleration. So if you add these two, TT will be cancelled, 1 plus 2 you do. G minus T is equal to A, T is equal to 2A. Sorry, T is equal to 5A, TT cancel, G is equal to 6A, A is equal to G by 6, G is nothing but 10 by 6, 2 5s, 2 3s, 5 by 3 meter per second square is the acceleration of the string. That means this body is accelerating 5 by 3. What is 5 by 3? 5 by 3 is nothing but 3 ones are 3, 2 remainder 1.66 meter per second square. Sir, why acceleration decreases? In last problem we got 5 meter per second, this time only 1.66. Why? Because 1 kg is very small mass, it is pulling 5 kg, so automatically acceleration is decreased. Suppose this is 1 kg, this is 5 kg, automatically the acceleration will be more. That problem you do, you take 5 kg here and 1 kg here, you do it, definitely you will get more acceleration. What is the acceleration? Write in comment section, right? Now acceleration is this, no? Now find the tension. Tension you can substitute directly from second equation. From equation 2, what do you get? T is equal to 5 into A. T is equal to 5 into A, 5 by 3. 5 5s are 25 by 3. That means 3 8s are 24. 1 8.33 newton is the tension in the string. 8.33 newtons. Tension? Acceleration is nothing but 5 by 3, 1.66 meter per second square. This is very important, children. How to find the acceleration if one body is at rest, another body is sliding. One body is suspended over a pulley, another body is on the smooth polished surface. Then what is the acceleration of the system, and find the tension of the system. Understand, children? No doubt. See, children, next problem. Here two pulleys are there. This is fixed pulley, this is movable pulley. This is fixed to the ceiling. This is a movable pulley. This is fixed pulley. Right here, I will write here. Fixed pulley. This is movable pulley. How to solve these kind of problems? See here, same question, find the tension and acceleration of the system. Find the tension and acceleration of the system. How to find mobile pulleys? Simple. How many strings are there? First find out those strings. This is one string attached to two over a pulley, attached to mobile pulley and attached to a ceiling. That means first string is fixed to the ceiling. It is attached to the string. We know tension, if a string is same, tension is same. This is tension T1. Here also tension T1. This is a tension acts by 2 kg on pulley. This is tension acts by pulley on 2 kg. These two are equal. This string is same, tension is same. This is also T1. Definitely this is also T1. This is a tension acts by this pulley on this pulley. This is a tension acts by movable pulley on fixed pulley. Here also tension T1 same. Tension, string changes, tension changes. This is T2, this is T2. This is the T2 tension acts by 1 kg on movable pulley. This is tension acts by movable pulley on 1 kg. Now we have to find the acceleration of the system. How to find the acceleration? Simple, again same. First of all, find, children, what is this tension T2 value? This tension T2 will be equal to, tension will be equal to sum of these two tensions only, no? T2 will be equal to 2T1, remember. Why? Because this total tension will be applicable here. Suppose this body comes 1 meter downwards, how much it goes up? This is, that if it comes 1 meter, this will be half, this will be half. Understand, children? That means it will be half of this one. If tension is T1 and T1, the total tension will be applicable here. This will be 2T. Now see, this weight is always acts downwards from the center. This is 2G. This weight is 1G. Make free body diagram. FBD of 2 kg I am writing first. FBD of 2 kg I am writing first. 2 kg downwards weight, 2G downwards, T1 upwards, T1 up, 2G down. Now what is the net force acting on the body? F is equal to ma. 5G downwards, 5G minus, sorry, 2G, no, 2G minus T1 is equal to ma. M is 2 into acceleration is a. This is equation number 1. Any doubt? Now FBD of 1 kg. FBD of 1 kg C. How to write FBD of 1 kg? Tell me. See here, 1 kg. Point mass. Take it as point mass. Upward T2. T2 is equal to 2T1. Downwards 1G. Now what is the total weight? F net is equal to MA. It is going upwards. So 2T1 minus G is equal to MA. 1 into A, directly I will write A. This is equation number 2. If you solve these two, you will get A value, T1 value. T1 value, if you substitute in T2, then you will get T2. See here, first I am adding these two. Before going to add here, two, either T1 is there, here 2T1 is there. This total equation I am going to multiply with 2. 1 is multiplied by 2. Then I am adding with equation number 2. Equation number 1 is multiplied by 2. Then after I am adding with 2. Then what will happen? 2T1, 2T1 will get cancelled. Observe here. 2 into 2G, 4G minus 2 into T4, 2T1, 2T1 is equal to 4A. Now this equation as is right. 2T1 minus G is equal to A. Add these two. 2T1, 2T1 gets cancelled. 4G minus G. 3G is equal to 5A. G value 10. 3 tens are 30 is equal to 5A. A is equal to 30 by 5. 5 meter per second square is the acceleration of the system. What is the acceleration of the system? 6 meter per second square. Any doubt, children? Acceleration is 6 meter per second square. Small correction, children. If it accelerates upwards with A, then what will be the acceleration of this one? 2A. Small correction. If this pulley goes with A acceleration, this pulley comes with 2A acceleration. This is nothing but M into A. M is 2, 2 into 2, 4A. This is 4A. 2 into 2, 2G minus 2T1 is equal to 2 4s are 8A. 2T minus G is equal to A. So, 3G is equal to 9A. A is equal to nothing but 3G by 9. 3G by 3 ones, 3 threes. So, A is equal to G by 3 meter per second square is the answer. This is what acceleration. Once again, children, here remember two things. If a mobile pulley accelerates A upwards, why? Because this will be A by 2, A by 2. If it is A, A plus A, it comes down with 2A. This acceleration will be double than this acceleration. If it goes with 1 meter per second square, 2 meter per second square. If it goes 2 meter per second square, it comes with 4 meter per second square. Why? Because two strings are separated. These two strings, the sum of these two strings acceleration will be single string acceleration. So, acceleration, the sum of acceleration is equal to total acceleration. A plus A is equal to 2A. Now, this A value you substitute in this equation, you will get T1. Simple. T1 minus G is equal to A. What is A? G by 3. 2T1 minus G is equal to G by 3. 2T1 is equal to minus G goes to that side means plus G. G plus G by 3 how much? LCM 3. 4G by 3. 2 ones, 2 twos. So 2G by 3. T1 is equal to 20 by 3 Newton. This is the tension in first string. This total string, the tension is 20 by 3. 20 by 3 means nothing but 3, 6 or 18, 6.33 something, 6.33 Newton. 20 by 3 also enough. 6.33 Newton is the tension in first string. How do you get tension in second string? T1 is multiplied by 2. So, 40 by 3. T2 is 40 by 3. T2 is 2T1, no? 2 into T1 is 20 by 3. 2 into 20 by 3, that is nothing but 40 by 3 Newton is the tension in second string. In this string, tension is 40 by 3. Here, 20 by 3, acceleration is G by 3, 10 by 3. 10 by 3 means nothing but 3.33. This is what movable pulley, fixed pulley problems. I will do one more video some more problems. This is what almost 1 hour video. More than that, the mobile do not allowing more than one hour video. Some more problems I will do in another video. These are different types of models in auto admission. That is what Newton's second law. Practice once. You have to practice once. So many problems you will get from worksheet. I also will upload worksheet later. Any doubts, write in comment section. Practice. All the best. God bless you.